In previous tutorial, we talked about how to display 3D model on your website with 3.js. Now in this tutorial, we are going to show you how to set up a light and shadow to make your model look more realistic. Ready? Let's check it out. So first, let's start with downloading a free 3D model on Sketchfab. You can register a free account to download a free model. And here's the downloaded content. Let's put it to your web directory. Now this project is going to need to import three JavaScript files. First is 3.js core file. The second one is orbitcontrols.js for the camera control. And the last one is gltf loader for loading 3D model. You can find all of these in 3.js zip file from the official site. The orbit control is inside the example/control folder. And the gltf loader is in the example/loaders. First, I'm going to declare necessary global variables: scene, camera, renderer, and orbit control. And start with creating a scene and set up the background color to light gray. Then set up a perspective camera with 60-degree viewing angle. Using current window aspect ratio and 5000 units viewing frustum. Then place the camera away from the origin point. Also enable the orbit control so we can use mouse to rotate the camera. This time, I'm going to also add axis helper. This will add XYZ axis to the scene for easier during development. Then set up the WebGL renderer using current window size. And add the scene to our page as canvas element. Finally, create our rendering loop function. Inside, we will use renderer to render the scene using our camera. And call itself recursively using request animation frame. And that should do for the basic scene setup. You should see axis helper on the page now. Next, I'm going to load 3D model. We'll create a gltf loader and call a load method and pass the location of the gltf file. And provide the callback function when the loading is finished. Sometimes a single gltf file contains more than one object, so we need to select the first child and add it to our scene. I will also start the render loop after we load the model. Now you will notice two things. First, the model is pitch black. This is because we haven't set the light yet. And another one is the model position is not at the origin point. This happens sometimes and it depends on how the model was created. So first, let's move the model back to the origin point. and next set up the light. I'm going to set up a hemisphere light, which is a light positioned directly above the scene and fading from the sky color to the ground color. This is similar to the reflection of the sunlight during the day. I'm going to use a pale orange as a sky color and gray for the ground with 4 intensity. Now we can see the model, but the color is too saturated and unrealistic. We can fix that by changing the color tone mapping. For this project, I'm going to use a Reinhardt tone mapping, which has balanced HDR amount. You can try other tone mapping types in Three.js for various results. But this will make the scene dimmer, so I will also increase the exposure. Next, I'm going to add a spotlight. This will represent the main source of the light, like the sun. I will use the orange-yellow color with 4 intensity. We'll need this light to cast shadows, so I will set the cast shadow property to true. Then inside the rendering loop, I will use the camera position to update the light position with a small offset. This is a trick to simulate the real-world dynamic light sources. Now you will notice that the shadow is still invisible. We'll fix that. First, we'll need to iterate through all mesh in the model and set the cast shadow and receive shadow properties to true. We can do that using traverse method and update the properties if the object is a mesh. Then we'll need to enable the shadow map in our renderer. The shadow is visible now, but this time you will see some artifacts. Also, the shadow resolution is horrible. Again, we'll fix that. First, we can remove the shadow artifacts by decreasing shadow bias. This will reduce the shadow sensitivity. And next, we can increase the shadow resolution by increasing the map size to a multiplier of 1024. And next, we'll increase the texture filtering quality by increasing anisotropy property of the model texture map. Looks good. Now I'm going to replace the background with cubemap texture I have and remove the axis helper, and here's the final result. And that's the basic of the light and shadow setup in Three.js. Hope you guys enjoy. If you want to see more development tips and tutorials, subscribe this channel to stay tuned. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye.